So we are here in last and third part of our lesson. Odhavji Bhai Raghavji Patel, the father of folklore. So we are seeing here that how a science teacher started a business and developed it that it reached to the international level. So we will see that what happened further and what he has to say about it and what the journey led ahead it. All this diversification are based on the model of low price and high volume. So we have seen in earlier lectures that he has and his company has produced so many appliances and things, and every stuff has based on low price and high quality. The strategies has been to influence the strong distribution manufactured exploiting available resources with the company. The maximizes the group business and also popularizes its brand. So the way they are working with the different strategies to value the money of a customer, so it became a brand. His commitment to social responsibility is noteworthy. When he was asked why the total of then 7,000 plus employee at Ajanta, more than 5,000 women, Odhavji Bhai replied. So when he was asked that you have 70,000 people working for you, but 5,000 people are women, why? So he replied that women are more sincere and less prone to wasting time at work, thus proving to be far more productive than men. See, this is the some tactic, some way of working of women, that they work more hardly and more precisely and with tenderness. Employing women was a big business potential with social implications. He therefore decided to employ them. The other thing that not women, he gave work to women not just because they do work good, but it's kind of a social activity that women need to be empowered. So that is the another thing which helped women around him, the villages of any area, that they could earn by themselves, that they became independent, they can be empowered. So it worked as social level too. His son Jaisukh Patel says his father's employment of women is linked to the water harvesting revolution, in which the family also was involved with a series of droughts in the late 70s and 90s in the Saurashtra region. Jaisukh Bhai pioneered the movement to build dams and recharge groundwater. So whenever they gave work to women, it also Jaisukh Bhai linked it this revolution with the droughts, the drought when it was held in area of Saurashtra around 70s and 90s. This brought about a revolution in the village of Hardwad, Vaker, Drol, Jodia and Morbi, and helped to stop migration of workers from the Saurashtra region. So that was a time because of the drought, people were leaving the places and going somewhere they can find water. But because of this building dams which they built, people tried to stay their places, and that kind of a revolution they brought. So because of that thing, people got job in farms, they don't have to go somewhere else. It is due to this revolution that the men in the Saurashtra region returned to agriculture, and others who had migrated to South Gujarat began making a mark for themselves in the diamond polishing business, leaving the women alone. So what happens when the few people who stayed here and started to work in agriculture because they now getting the water, and the other people who moved, they were started to work in a diamond polishing. So women were alone because they moved, so the women are behind here alone. So they are here and the men working somewhere else in a diamond polishing, so they are kind of alone and they are not doing anything. So for the solution of that thing, he started that women should work here. That going to be another reason that he gave work to them. If you wanted to employ them, you have to provide employment near their home. I traveled to every village nearby, convinced village leaders to send their daughters and sisters to work. So if you want to make employ them, we have to give employment, we have to give work them to near home, because in their system, in their society, people were not letting their daughter or their daughter-in-law or sisters or wife to go work somewhere else. So if you want to make them work, we have to provide jobs near their homes. So what he did, however, it was not that easy, and it was only when he decided to set an example from within the family that women gradually came to believe and to work. The wife of Uddhavji Bhai's elder son started working in the factory. So if you want to set an example, you have to become an example. So what happened that his son's wife started to work in a factory. So it can give some inspiration to other women that if she can work, we can work too. Even it gives example to the other men that man's woman can work here, our woman can work here too. So that kind of example he said. Then the female domestic help were persuaded. Gradually, women from 45,000 surrounding villages such as Padhari, Tankara, Madia, Drol and Morbi begin working at Ajanta factory. Even today, Ajanta provides transport facility to employees. So the other small villages, women started to work here, and if they are living in some little bit farther area, so they have provided the bus system so they can come and go, transport system so they can come and go easily. They learn discipline, hard work, value of time and money at our factory. They work without any fuss. All this learning help in running their family and dealing with their family members and people around. This has helped make society better, says Uddhavji Bhai. So educating women, making them work, women, not it is good for her family, but it is for society too. Uddhavji Bhai knew that, so that's why he put this idea in his work. Uddhavji Bhai also helped to run hostel for more than 50,000 girls and boys in the region, providing food, boarding and study material. So he was also established hostels, and in his different hostels, more than 50,000 girls and boys used to live. He recently helped to collect more than rupees 78 crores from the people of Saurashtra to meet the financial needs of the hostel. His family says he remained humble all through his life. If someone tries to change his wardrobe with new clothes, telling him that he is the father of the empire that has turned over in crores, he gets angry and shows off his pension of rupees 1200. He lived very humble throughout his life, that whenever someone tried to show that he is actually a millionaire, he always show his pension, that I am a simple retired teacher whose pension is 1200. That's it. Means whatever money he was earning from the business is just giving to again business. He was not using for himself. He say that he is just a retired teacher. It cannot afford new clothes every time, says Jaisukh Bhai, director of Ajanta Group. How simple the person is. When we get little bit amount of money, we just cannot hold the importance of it, we cannot hold the joys of it, but it is not for the people who is actually billionaire but still humble and decent. Uddhavji Bhai is from them. The group's brand Ajanta, Orpet and Oreva are sold in 45 countries. We have already discussed it. The company sells diverse products such as switches, snacks, electric bikes, tube lights, telephones, calculator and watches, to name a few. Besides wall clocks, the group planned to venture into cement and car manufacturing as well. So we are here seeing that different kinds of stuff they are manufacturing. He said, I would continue to remain a teacher till the last breath of my life. As for the business, it is now for my son to take it forward. But I must tell them one thing, if they want their business to prosper, they have to give their customer value for their money in terms of price and quality. This is some kind of a premise of Karsanbhai Patel, value for money, quality work, quality production, and that is how, this is only how you will prosper. Time stood still at the Ajanta Group, the world's biggest wall clock manufacturer, on 18th December 2012 as its founder Odavji Bhai Raghavji Bhai Patel died at the age of 87 in Morbi. He was suffering from suffocating and taking breath problems and was on ventilator support for 2 months at his residence in Gujarat, Saurashtra region. So this was your lesson which we had completed. Next we will see question answer segment of the lesson which will complete the lesson and the lecture. Describe his commitment toward the social responsibility. If we understand that how social he person was, that he had, when he began his job, he actually started to provide diesel to the farmer, then he built some dams, and also on the responsibility level, he started to give jobs to the women so they can empower, their family and they can empower their society. So you just find out that thing and write it down. What Odavji Bhai used to think about women employers? He used to think that women work more hard way and they work consciously without making any fuss. So the tenderness making of mechanism of a watch needs, women can do it. That's why he used to give work to women. Describe water harvesting revolution in some area of Saurashtra. So when they about to start their business, it happened that people from Saurashtra area used to leave their places and wish to go somewhere else because they are facing the drought in late 17th and 19th in that area. So what they did, that they actually built some dams and recharged the groundwater. So what happened when the people of that area started to get water, they started to stay there and took part in agriculture. So that kind of a revolution that brought. How Odavji Bhai set example about women working in the factory. So it was not easy to bring women from their houses because the social restriction. So how to do that? So first they started to make women of their houses, of their sons, to start to work in a factory. So this is how they set the example, which gave inspiration to the other women and their family. So after that they started to work here, and that kind of a example they set, that if they can work of being a woman of a millionaire, you can work too, and it is a good thing. Provide names of other production of the group beside wall clocks. There is so many home appliances, and then vitrified tiles and CFLs. So there are so many things which you can find out from the lesson, and you can put it here. When and how Odavji Bhai died? So he died on 18th December 2012. He died at the age of 87 because having a problem of a respiratory. He was on ventilator for 2 months in his residence in Gujarat, Saurashtra region. So this was your fourth lesson and third part, and we, after it, we have completed 4 lessons. Now only one lesson, which is actually a story, remains. We will complete it after in next week.